gonna scoop out your brain and eat your eyeballs.
I beg your pudding.
I'm gonna scoop out your brain and eat your eyeballs.
Master Dave, if I've done anything to offend you...
Oh, no, it's the name of a horror film. Oh. It's part of a horror night on digital.
Mm.
I'm gonna scoop out your brain and eat your eyeballs, followed by The Zombie Electrician and Blood Disco. It's gonna be mental.
Master Dave, as a responsible adult fox, I have to say you are far too young to be watching films like that. However, as a fox who loves horror flicks, I say, bring on the gore.
Personally, I don't like horror films. All that screaming, nasty things lurking in the corner, a constant threat of danger.
Yeah, you get enough of that in your own kitchen. Boom, boom! What are you doing, Mr. Stephen?
I'm practicing my evil face. I'm going for an audition as a villain tomorrow.
Oh, they must be hard up. You, a villain.
I make a very good villain, actually.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, watch this. So, Mr. Brush, we meet again!
You will not escape me this time, 007!
Double O, dear me, more like. I've been more scared watching the Teletubbies.
Hi, guys. Yeah. I think there's been a mix-up. I've been waiting for a parcel, but I got this address to Basil instead, and it stinks.
Ooh, well, I am sorry.
No, I mean it literally stinks here. Smell.
Blimey, that really honks.
I know what this'll be. Open it up, Mr. Stephen. Go on.
Do I have to?
Yes, come on, help me out.
It's cheese.
Yeah, and not just any old cheese. This is a vintage cheddar, eh? And it's from an old friend of mine who runs the smelliest cheese farm in Somerset.
So, have you got my parcel?
Oh, let's have a look.
Thanks. I've joined a book club.
Oh, is that where books go to hang out?
So what's this one about then?
It's an encyclopedia of dreams. Whatever dream you have, this book will tell you exactly what it means. For instance, Stephen, what was the last dream you had? Stephen, it made me the happiest girl alive.
Can't remember.
And what about you, Basil?
Oh, I never dream, Miss Ella. My life is so exciting, so dramatic, I don't need to.
Hi, everyone. Oh, what is that smell?
Someone sent Basil some cheese in the post.
Hate mail, was it?
Oi.
Anyway, are we ready to let the horror commence?
What's this?
Oh, Master Dave and I are planning a big horror film extravaganza.
Oh, no.
What's the matter?
Oh, yeah. I forgot. Stephen don't like horror films. He gets all scared.
I don't. I've just got a nervous disposition, that's all.
Mm. Yeah, right. Are we taking the mickey out of Stephen for being a scaredy cat?
I am not a scaredy cat.
A bit too scary for you, is it, Mr. Stephen?
No. I'm fine.
Stephen, you're such a girl. Oi! That's offensive to girls.
I'm worried about you kids. I mean, we just don't know the long-term effects of watching scary movies.
I know the short-term effects. I'm starving. I think I'm going to eat my special cheese.
Oh, no, not that horrible smelly thing.
Go on, Mom. Go and fetch it for me. Go on, grab it.
Okay. but I'm going prepared.
Isn't it a bit late to be eating cheese?
Why? Is it going out of fashion?
No. But you know what they say? Cheese before bed gives you nightmares.
That, Mr. Stephen, is an old wife's tale.
How do you know?
The old wife told me.
That is one serious pom.
Right. Who wants a slice?
Not me. I can't stand the smell. Right, I'm off to bed.
Me too. Me three.
But, Master Dave, we've still got four more horror movies to watch yet.
That stinks enough horror for me. I'm off.
Ah, go on then. See if I care. All the more cheese for me then.
And if it gives you nightmares, don't blame us.
Pah! Nightmares. Right, Mr. Cheese? Time you and I got down to business. What a lot of cheddar. Well, that's worn me out, that is. Time for bed.
And now, on Horror Night, an old classic. Ooh. Drink the blood of Dracula.
Oh, I like this one. Oh, why don't you stay for a couple more hours? And then I'll... And then I'll... Then I'll... It was just a clock striking. And if you saw the amount clocks get paid round here, you'd strike as well. God, it's a bit creepy, this, isn't it? Mr. Stephen, are you playing that BBC sound effects tape again? Mr. Stephen? Blimey! Has Michael Jackson been in and redecorated while I was asleep? You know, if I didn't know better, I'd say I was in one of those low-budget horror films. But the writers would never do that. It would be terribly contrived and lazy.
We can't put him in a horror film because it'd be terribly contrived and lazy.
Yeah, but it's nearly 5 o'clock.
That's a good point.
A horror film, eh? God, wait till Mr. Stephen hears about this.
Hello, Basil.
Oh! Oh! Cool! Mr. Stephen, you shouldn't sneak up on someone like that. You nearly turned my brush white.
Is everything all right?
Well, no, as it happens, I think I'm having a nightmare. Which probably means that you're not Mr. Stephen. But you're just some horrible, scary monster from my imagination. Isn't that right, Mr. Stephen? Mr. Stephen? You're pudding, I beg.
Welcome to my castle.
It's a flat.
Castle.
Flat.
Castle.
Flat.
Okay, castle, but it's not important.
Yeah, quite right. The important thing is... Why are you dressed as a waiter?
I
am Count Stephen of Transylvania.
Me thinking you were unemployed, Stephen, of this flat.
Silence!
Stop it.
Please, accept my apologies. Can I get you anything? Perhaps a drink?
No thanks.
Of blood.
Definitely not then.
Or perhaps... a bite.
Still all cheesed up, Tar.
A bite.
In the jugular!
Hey! Hang on. Shouldn't you have big vampire teeth in?
Good point. Ah, that's better. Where were we?
You were just about to bite me.
Yeah!
this is getting to be a pain in the neck. I'm off. Right, where was I? Oh, yes, trapped in my own horror film. It was my own fault. I should never have eaten the cheese. I'm scared. And in case nobody ever sees me again, I'd like to pass a message on. Help! Oh, well, at least I should be safe here at Daniel's calf, as long as I don't eat the fish.
What was that about my fish?
Who said that?
It is I, Dr. Frankenstein. So, what brings you to my laboratory?
My feet.
You called, master?
No, he called Enil, me called Basil. What you called?
Ignore him, Igor. Everybody else does.
Igor, blimey. Did he fall out of the ugly tree and hit every branch on the way down?
Oi, that's very rude.
Oh, don't get the hump. Oh, I'm leaving. This is too weird, even for a talking fox. Phew. Oh, this nightmare's exhausting. If I wasn't already asleep, I'd have a kip. Oh, no! Help! Viewers! Oh, oh, I'm done for!
Hi, Basil.
Miss Ella. So, which horror film character are you, then?
I don't know what you're talking about, Basil. I'm just me, Ella.
Oh, no. That means you're that naive, innocent girl who's always the first one to get grabbed by the ghosts and ghoulies.
Leave it.
You want to tell me what you're talking about, you crazy fox?
Oh, I ate a lump of cheese and now I'm having a nightmare.
Oh, groovy.
What does it say in your encyclopedia about seeing vampires and mad scientists?
It says you've eaten too much cheese.
Yeah, all right, don't rub it in. What does it say about me seeing you in a rabbit costume?
Nothing.
Oh, well, never mind. It was worth it just to see what you look like.
Can I get out of this now?
Certainly. We mustn't keep rabbiting on. Time is bunny. I mean, money. Boom, boom.
Thank you.
Now, listen. You'd better stick with me, as the glue said to the people.
Mr. Stephen's gone very strange.
He tried to bite my neck.
He's tried to do that to me before. To be honest, it was more of a nibble.
Yes, but he tried to drink my blood.
I think he's one of the undead.
You mean he's joined the Rolling Stones?
Wait, I do the jokes around here, love, all right?
Now, come on, and be quiet. We don't want him to catch us. Oh, hold me, Michelle. I'm scared.
Oh, don't be silly, Basil. It's only a nightmare. There's nothing to worry about.
What was that you were seeing?
I'm not really scared. I've read about this. It's just nerve endings in my brain telling me to scream.
Cool. They've got a nerve.
Got a nerve.
Get it?
Shh. Oh, what's that down there?
Yikes! It's a
coffin!
No, I'm just stuttering, actually. No, it looks like Mr. Stephen's been to IKEA again and bought us a coffin table.
Coffin table.
Get it? Boom, boom! See, it proves it. Mr. Stephen's a vampire. Now, come on, let's get out of here, Miss Ella. Miss Ella? Miss Ella, don't tell me you've become a vampire as well.
Well, if you don't want me to, but frankly, that sort of attitude is just very vampire.
Well, I am sorry.
I suppose you want to bite me now, then?
Yes, please.
Well, in that case, stick it up your fangs, bat girl!
Ah! So glad you could join me.
My cape's stuck in the gears again. Could you give us a hand?
Come here. Honestly, you should get this thing fixed.
Yeah? Will you try getting a coffin mechanic out of this time of night?
Well, I'm just saying, it's not very impressive, is it?
Oh, you are always so critical.
Oi, 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 oi! Excuse me when you two have quite finished.
Sorry. Where were we?
We're going to bite the fox.
Yes. After all, Jamie Oliver does recommend we eat more basil.
You're just deliberately misunderstanding for the sake of a bad joke.
Yeah, like you never do that.
Oh, you're much more catty since you became undead.
Prepare to die, Basil. Hmm? You are doomed. Do you hear me?
Oh, yes, I heard you the first time. Why does everyone always repeat themselves in this nightmare?
Hang on.
If this is a nightmare, it doesn't matter if you bite me or not, does it?
Are you prepared to take that risk?
All right, then. But you've got to catch me first, big teeth. Blimey, this looks like it, viewers. Basil Brush gets it in the neck. I'm too scared to even boom, boom.
Can nobody save me?
No.
Stop right there, vampire scum. I am the fearless vampire hunter, Professor Van Hire.
Van Hire? Shouldn't that be Van Helsing?
Yes, I am like him, but I can also rent you a transit van. There's my card.
Good to have a sideline.
So, creatures of darkness, back!
Actually, I'm not very religious.
No, me neither.
Oh, it's no use, Miss Molly. Remember, they're actors. There's only one thing that will stop them. Here!
What is it?
A bad review of their performances. Read it out.
The acting is wooden.
Oh! It's working. Keep going.
The characterization of vampires is weak and unrealistic.
Don't do that! Oh, this is so unfair.
Oh, the critics don't understand the subtleties of this piece.
That should hold them for a while. I know just the thing to defeat vampires. Garlic bread.
Could we just use garlic?
Well, garlic bread's much nicer.
Quick, make some then. I think the review is wearing off.
Hey, they say the makeup looks really good.
Yeah, that is something. Ella, tell me honestly, do you think I've got a wide face?
I'll never get this finished in time.
Oh. Hello, Basil, do you want a hand?
God, blimey! It's celebrity chef Ross Burden.
How did you get in?
Well, I forced the lock, of course.
Oh, OK.
Now, bit of garlic bread. We need some parmesan, we need some parsley, we need some mozzarella.
Oi! Who's making this? Me or you, Mush?
I'm just trying to be helpful.
Well, if you want to help, pass me that wooden spoon, would you?
There you go.
Oi! Now clear off. Go on, hop it. Get out of my
Rachel
kitchen.
Vermin.
Go on, get lost. Hey, you haven't even washed your hands, you filthy pig.
Basil! Basil, hurry up!
I'm going as fast as I can, Miss Molly. I'm not a flipping galloping gourmet, you know. Okay. First, get your bread. Molly, have we got any bread?
Any time now, Basil!
Just putting it in the oven now, Miss Molly.
Don't forget, gas mark 6, Basil.
Neff off.
Basil! Get out of it, vampire scum!
That's my geranium!
Stephen, we're supposed to be scary. Forget the geranium.
Sorry.
He's fond of fences, look now.
Miss Molly, the garlic bread's ready. God, you're going to get it now, you vampires. Oh, I say, Miss Molly, you knew what would go well with this. Steak.
Boom, boom.
I'm afraid it's too late, Basil.
He got to you as well, Miss Molly. Could this get any worse? Cranky!
Why not become a vampire? It's so easy and so good for dinner parties.
Not you as well.
Don't forget me.
And us, Basil.
Why not become one of us?
Oh, no! Trapped! Well, this is it. The end. And to think, only yesterday, the only heartless bloodsucker I knew was my agent. Hello! What's happening? No vampires? Flat back how it was? Well, what do you know? It was all a dream. Who's eating all the cheese?
We're going to miss kickoff if we don't finish.
He wakes up. It was all a dream. The end. That'll do.
The next morning, and everyone is back to normal. Well, normal by their standards, which is pretty weird.
And you were there, Mr. Stephen. And you were there, and you were there, and you were there, and you were there, and you... You weren't there. Who are you?
Me? Sorry, someone had forced the lock. I just, walked in. But, thanks for the tea. Gotta go. Bye.
Bye.
Only you could fiddle that into one nightmare, Basil.
Well, I did eat a lot of cheese.
I'm giving up on this book. Last night has proved that there are some dreams that you'll just never understand.
Yeah, too right. But anyway, I'm very pleased you're not a vampire, Mr. Stephen.
A vampire? Yeah. How ridiculous.
Preposterous. So silly.
Crazy.
Yeah, everyone knows Stephen's a werewolf.
Quite. I beg your pudding. Well, Mr. Stephen, that was quite a show. Dreaming you were all vampires and finding out you're actually a werewolf. I didn't see that one coming. God, anyway, time for sleep. You all right down there, Mr. Stephen? You know, viewers, I sometimes think this show has gone to the dogs. Or should I say, wolves.
Yeah.
Presenting BB3B in Zombie Pizza Eaters.
And they all lived happily ever after, except those who escaped in the time capsule, who lived happily ever before, and the Betachlorians, who were vaporized by photon torpedoes. But that's okay, because they were the bad guys. What a lovely story.
Again!
Now, come on, Lucy. You've heard that story 1,000 times. You need to sleep.
Actually, according to my story log, that's only the 985th time we've heard Space Terror from Quadrant X, but I'll let it slide.
Thanks, Louie. Ah, sigh?
Why not? It gets better with every read.
Yeah!
The galaxy was quiet that night. Too quiet.
Houston, we are not alone.
Whatever happened to the good old days, eh, Louie?
Invasion of the Draculons. Blood-sucking aliens invade planet Earth and turn everyone into brainless zombies.
True story, right?
Yeah, must be. It's in color. So, where did your mom and dad go tonight, anyway?
Nowhere. They're just driving the Sprog around in the car to try to stop it screaming.
Like in that movie.
What movie?
I don't know, but there was definitely a car in it.
It's the Draculons! They're invading! We're all doomed! I'm sorry, my mistake. It's just Mom and Dad.
Hi, Mr. Jenkins. Mrs. Jenkins. So, what's up with the little guy anyway?
Teeth, George. He's getting his first teeth.
Hot dang! Oh, I got me the loudest grandson in the whole U.S. of A.
Well, if I'm not going to get any shut-eye, I may as well do something useful. Hello? Is that Mr. Weinberger?
Where?
Sorry to call at this hour, but we just had to tell you the good news.
You've won our competition. Oh, yeah? What?
Your prize. Well, Mr. Whiny Baby Burger, it's a free meal at the grand opening of the newest restaurant in town, the Leaning Tower of Pizza.
Right.
Tomorrow night, 8 o'clock. Our company representative will meet you there. Good night, Mr. Wonderful. I mean, Weinberger.
All right.
Whee! Come tomorrow night. Pizza won't be the only dish on the menu. You're going to be miney, my little whiny shminey. Oh, if I'm going on a date, I better clean my teeth.
No nasty Draculan alien's gonna bite this neck.
Thanks, Lucy. Hey, crying stopped.
You say crying? I say alien war cry!
Yeah, the Draculons have got a seriously cool war cry. Roar! You're cool.
Chubba, you do know it's traditional for babysitters to go home at the end of the night?
Not an option, little guy. All-night sci-fi marathon on Channel Z.
Chubba, how do you tell if someone's been turned into a zombie?
Zombie spotting, huh? Well, they walk kind of funny. You know, like slow and stiff. And they bump into things quite a bit, too. They're not themselves anymore. No, everything in their minds has been totally, wiped. And don't forget the eyes. Dead eyes, man. That's a zombie, all right.
This is Radio, I forget. I'm so... What was that racket last night? I mean, was that piercing or what?
The whole town's infected.
Bye-bye.
Okay, don't panic, Louie. But our parents are officially zombies.
Lucy, breakfast is canceled. We've got to save the world. Oh, I don't want to be turned into a zombie, Lucy. What would they say at school?
No one's turning us into anything, Louie. I'll make sure of that.
Chubba, how do you stop Dracula and aliens from biting you?
Draculons? Whoa, they're real hard guys. Garlic is about the only thing they don't dig.
Garlic! Of course! What's garlic?
Well, it's you get it in food. You know, in pizza.
Leaning a tower of pizza, grand opening tonight if you fancy a bite. Take away, yes, we do that too.
20 garlic pizzas, please, with extra garlic.
But of course, madam. Hang on, you aren't a kid, are you? I have heard of your practical jokings and your Bertha Simpson. I am no idiot. Very well, what's your address, Mrs. Skywalker?
This is hopeless. We're never gonna find any garlic in this mess. We're as good as zombies.
Chubba! You're eating our ammunition!
Oh, Chubba!
Shh! Look, I've just got the baby off to sleep, so keep it down. Oh, in fact, why don't you go to work with your father?
But Dad went to work ages ago.
No, he's asleep in the car. He's been called in to sort out a teething problem with the new pizza restaurant.
Is that the restaurant which is supposed to be falling over?
And Dad made a straight one?
Well, just go and see your father.
That's that, then. No garlic to defend ourselves. Why don't we put on signs saying, bite me?
No way! Any Dracula tries it with me, I'll bite him right back!
With these. Where did you get those?
On Nana's windowsill.
Oh, cool.
This is a calamity! Oh, whopper! Empathy, my thief!
Thief?
Yes! I had a date with Mr. Weinberg! I'm desperate!
Okay. You're freaking me out, dude. Is it something to do with, pizza?
Where the pizzas come from?
There'll be tons of garlic in here.
You are architect. You build my tower straight. But it's called Leaning a Tower of Pizza. You know why? Because it's supposed to lean. You make me a laughing stock. See? Are you asleep?
What? Asleep? No. I was just shutting my eyes to think. I always think best with my eyes shut.
You see, Mr. Simon, with the tower standing astride, everything inside it is wrong. It's impossible.
Oh, dear. Yes.
I see what you mean.
When I was a boy back in Italy, I have this dream. I see how people come from all over the world to see the Leaning Tower. They don't say, what's wrong with this tower? They say, oh, nice one. doesn't make a change from the stupid straight one they got in France. So I dreamed that one day I would have my own restaurant in America, and I would make it a little to the side so the people would come. And everything inside it would lean also, so that people, they could sit and eat my beautiful pizzas. Bah!
Don't worry, Mr. Salmonelli. I'm sure it's just the tilting controls in the basement. They'll need adjusting. Done in a jiffy.
Mr. Salmonelli, where's the garlic?
The what?
The bathroom. She needs the bathroom.
Over there, but don't mess anything up. The grand opening's tonight.
The bathroom? What'd you say that for?
I don't trust Mr. Salmonelli. There's something weird about him.
You just worked that out, Louis Einstein?
Leaning a tower of pizza. Yes, yes, 20 more pizzas. Easy on the garlic. We will deliver at once, Mr. Chiaba.
Okay, Luce. According to my alien handbook, on entering unfamiliar territory, we should first assess the situation, size up our options, then and only then proceed with caution. Lucy?
Let's talk more garlic hunting, Louis!
Hey, Igor! I nearly forget! 20 more takeaway pizzas on the double for a Mr. Chiaba!
More pizzas for Chiaba?
Who are you? And what are you doing in my kitchen?
Emergency pizza packers! Heard you had a rush on!
About time. I got proper meals to prepare. Over there, get started.
Still, it does not lean!
What are you doing? He'll see!
Dear Chiaba, S.O.S. No garlic. Takeaway delivery ready to go!
Oh, darling, it can be my turn again.
Darling? Ha! Are you asleep when my tower is still astride?
Oh, sorry, Mr. Salmonelli. I was just having a really deep think.
It's no good, Mr. Simon. I have 15 waiters on the way, all with the special leaning shoes.
Sauce and no garlic.
Chiaba!
Oh, come on, dude.
Hello?
Hi, dude. Hey, what's all this sauce and no garlic? I asked for my pizza.
Shut up and listen. It's Lucy here.
Hey, Luce! You having fun?
Hardly. Listen, Chiaba, this garlic stuff's impossible to find!
Well, follow your nose, man. Garlic's, like, totally smelly. Real bad stink.
Ah, my waiters. At least something is going right.
You still there, Luce?
Yeah, it was Mr. Salmonelli. He's one guy we don't want to get on the wrong side of.
Tell me, waiter, where was your last restaurant? Well, what is wrong? Why don't you reply?
Excuse me, Mr. Salmonelli. We all just arrived here from Italy, and most not yet to learn the English.
Ha! No problemo. I speak to you in our mother tongue. Okay, Italiano, si?
Si, si bene.
When you find the garlic, just make sure you take out the Dracula leader first, yeah? Once you take him out, all the zombies return to normal.
A leader? Now he tells us.
Okay, Mastermind, how do we know who the leader is?
Okay, first of all, it looked pretty scary. Bound to be surrounded by zombie followers.
Anything else?
Oh, yeah. They'll probably talk in some weird alien language, too.
Questo è il ristorante. Tu sei responsabile per ogni tavolo. E ricordate, alcuni americani sono molto grassi, per cui ti accadrà...
Chubba, if we don't make it out of here, what should have my CDs, okay?
Cool.
Okay. There's nothing in the handbook about stumbling right into a head Draculon's base. We'll have to take this one step at a time, Lucy. Lucy? I'm starting to think you have no respect for the handbook.
All we need to do is find the garlic...
Which you can't find.
Find the garlic, hit Mr. Salmonelli with it, and all the zombies will turn back to normal. Easy!
Lucy, nothing's ever that easy.
Delivery, garlic bread!
Ah, music to my nostrils.
Did I hear my garlic bread delivery? Hey, what are you doing?
Keeping it warm?
Thieves!
I'm warning you, we're armed!
Luce, garlic only works on Draculons. He's a zombie!
Huh?
Oh, I'll bite you!
Right. Now let's see if this does it.
Think he meant by they?
More Dracula and aliens? Zombies? Who knows? It won't matter once we get him with our garlic UFOs!
Okay, Lucy. We need to select a target, determine trajectory, and... I know. Less talk, more action. Fire at will, soldier!
All right!
Must have shorted it out. Maybe if I turn the power off and on again.
Oh no, we lost the lights!
It must be part of a zombie plot! Louie, look! It's his zombie armies! We've got to get Mr. Salmonelli before they get us!
Nope, that's not it.
Are you?
Too late!
Get them! Prendili! Prendili!
Where's the handbook? Why did I throw away my handbook?
Okay, Lou. Here's what we gotta do. You're the quarterback. Now this one's out of the shotgun. I'm gonna run to Elwood, so you play fake run. As soon as I'm through the secondary, you gotta sprint by Elwood to put something on it, because I wanna spike this baby in, so got that?
Huh?
Just throw it!
Not an alien in sight, and all the zombies are back to normal.
We are total Draculon slayers!
Hey! Good to see that Chubba helped to sort out that leaning tower problem, too.
No, I had a pizza for lunch, so maybe a salad.
Hey?
Hey, only kidding, dude! Double Lug's pizza stack, police!
Curse Igor, that stupid old chef, running away on the opening night! Bah!
Mr. Weinberger, we have a telephone message. Ladies say, I'm so derby swabby, but something at the quap top. Can you ever forbid me? Wobbleful beer for wobble you. Oh, that is so sad. Now I think you must pay the bill.
Why is it so whiny, smiley?
A fine celebration feast.
That'll show you know who to try get one over at us, eh, Louie?
The Fat Albert Halloween Special! Hey, hey, hey! Gotta get those costumes today!
Yeah! Root and Rummage, they got a lot of cool Halloween costumes for tonight.
I'm gonna give me a superhero costume.
I'm gonna be a monster.
What do you mean, gonna be?
You already are.
Hey, Mr. Root, me and Devery here want some service. We got a whole $1.87 to spend clear.
Yeah, knock it off. Don't you see I'm busy with Mrs. Bakewell?
Okay, we'll just look around a bit. Ah! What's with you, Fat Albert? Don't you see that spooky old lady Bakewell?
So what?
So what? She lives in that creepy old house by the cemetery. Yeah, she sneaks around, never hardly talks to nobody. She's weird.
She's no weirder than any other old woman.
That's the trouble. All old people are weird. Hey, Rudy! Hand me that ladder. Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
Ah! Hey, you kids, out!
See, Fat Albert, just like Devery said, old people are mean.
Hey, hey, hey! Dig these cool homemade outfits.
Yeah, who needs store-bought costumes anyway?
Hey, small change. Tell me again, what's that stupid costume you're wearing?
My giant outfit.
A shrimp like you?
Sure, I'm the world's smallest giant.
Really dumb. Hey, now lay your eyes on these threads. I'm a clown!
We know that, but where are you dressed at?
Hey, ole, ole, ole! Feast your eyes on the greatest toreador on earth.
We dig.
You do?
Yeah, you're the world's champ at throwing the bull.
Scaring old dudes.
Hey, shake a leg. We gotta meet Devery at the graveyard.
Yay! All right! Oh, yeah, come on, man, let's go!
Oh, yay!
Watch it, Fat Albert.
Sorry, Rudy. Hey, what's the deal here anyway?
Cool it. You'll find out soon enough, Super Fats. Let's get out of here. I don't like this place.
Yeah. Well, if you're all too chicken.
Chicken.
Who's chicken?
Who you calling chicken?
Not me. I'm not chicken, man. What you got here? Chicken.
I am. Now, we're gonna see something that'll knock your eyes out.
Sure put one over on you dudes. Yeah, boyfriend Albert, I wish you could have seen the look on your face when I popped out.
Listen, Devery, that's not cool to go around shocking people.
Fat Albert, how could anyone be so round and so square at the same time?
I don't care. You shouldn't scare these dudes like that.
What do you mean, scared? I wasn't scared.
Yeah, I wasn't scared.
I was! All you clowns were scared. I had you quacking in your boots.
Not quacking, quaking.
Quacking, quaking, and shaking, and that's no faking. That's nothing to what me and Devery got planned for that old grouch later on tonight.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, really?
Really?
What's that?
Huh? Tell me now.
But first, we're gonna have some preliminaries before the main event. First, we're gonna scare old Searchlight Johnson at the movie house.
Hey, guys, I don't think we should.
Yeah, then we can scare old Mudfoot Brown.
Yeah, that'll be cool.
And the climax of the Fright Night festivities will be to get you know who. This is one Halloween weird old lady Bakewell is never gonna forget.
Hey, dudes. Before you get too far gone scaring old folks.
What's wrong with you?
Don't waste yourself.
Gotta get to the big horror movie before the early show prices change.
Yeah, but the main thing is that we're really gonna suck it to old Searchlight Johnson.
Yeah, all the way through there.
Oof, shoving.
Valerie, Mama grounded you. You gotta go home.
Well, looky here. The eyes, ears, nose, and throat of the world.
You're gonna get in big trouble.
Fly! Aren't you scared of creepy things?
No, you don't bother me at all.
Get lost, Melba. Come on, gang.
I'm warning you. Mom and Pop find out you're in big trouble.
Hey, she won't really tell on you, will she? Nah, I got her buffaloed.
I don't want you kids messing around. Keep your feet off the seats, keep your lips zipped.
Hey, follow me up to the balcony. We'll dim old Searchlight's bulb for him.
Dr. Nordenberger, hurry. We have to get past those creepy, icky space squids. Watch it, Dr. Nordenberger. The creepy, icky space squids are going to dive bomb us.
Space squids going to get me!
Shut up.
Yes, but there's a worse threat overhead. Yes, Dr. Nordenberger, it's super space squid.
Out. And you too, wise guy. O-U-T, out. Man, that was the funniest thing I ever saw.
Not funny, Devery.
You got us kicked out of the best part, too.
I did not. It was that mean old Searchlight Johnson. Oh, dudes just like him got no sense of humor.
You don't have no sense of humor and no sense either.
Quit your belly aching. The fun is only beginning. Follow me.
Hey, all right.
Hey,
all right.
Come on, cool it, Devery. Why don't we just do some more trick-or-treating without scaring the old folks?
Hey,
don't be such a drill.
Let's scare somebody, man. What's wrong?
Now that that's settled, Captain Plump Lump, can we get on with the business of the evening? Our next victim lives right over there.
Hold it. We don't want to scare old Mudfoot. What did he ever do anyway?
He got old, that's what. Come on, Rudy. Let's show these bush leaguers how to do a big league scare. I hear you. Let's go.
With all this racket going on. Hey, Mudfoot, you know what we're here for? Lay some treats on us. You know, when I was a kid, trick-or-treating was different. Talking about fun, we didn't have no signal lights. And I used to wear the darkest clothes I could find so nobody could see me. Yes, sir. Nothing like a challenge of crossing a dark, busy street.
That don't sound like much fun to me.
Won't catch me crossing no dark street. No.
Noble Saber.
That's asking for it.
That's bad. That's
too cold, yeah.
Then there wasn't all this frou-frou about taking treats that was prepackaged. Yeah, I wish you could have seen the good slop I ate. You're a taste lint-covered licorice taffy apple popcorn peanut orange donut peppermint divinity fudge all globbed together in one big gritty gooey wad. Oh, man. Not like all this sissy sanitary pre-wrap goody two-shoe stuff you get today. Of course, at least you get sick in dogs and spend 2-3 days in bed, but it's worth it.
Hey, I don't care what you say. I ain't gonna eat nothing but wrapped up goodies.
Yeah,
me neither.
No way.
Well, I gotta see my TV shows now. You better get going with your trick and treating.
Okay, all right, but so long. I'll see you.
All right. put on my foot. He's a cool old dude, ain't he?
Yeah, he's real cool.
You dudes are D-U-M, dumb.
What are you talking about?
That old dude got away without giving nobody nothing.
Devilry?
Oh!
You better come home right now, or you're really gonna get in trouble.
Call it, call it.
You hear me, huh?
The whole world can hear you, Diesel Mouth.
Why do you call me Diesel Mouth?
Because your yap is so big you could drive a truck through it.
It's getting late. We all better go home.
Oh, yeah. Okay. We call it a night.
Time to go.
Right. It's all right with me.
We sure didn't do too good with the tricks or treats.
Hold it. Hold everything. We are forgetting the mostest, the baddest, the scariest part of the whole night.
Who could forget her?
Put me down.
I don't mean her. I mean her.
Put me down. Devilry, you're in big trouble with Mom and Dad. Mm-hmm.
Big trouble. Huh. Now hear this, shortbread. I'm not going home here. Me and my pals got to go up to that creepy old house and scare old lady Bakewell. Right, dudes?
I don't know.
Hey, I got something to say. You've been talking mighty big and bold all night about what us dudes should do. Now, just for a change, let's see you do something really heavy on your own.
Who? Me?
Yeah, Devry. Are you chicken?
You jiving? My brother Devery's no chicken. He's a lame duck with no pluck.
Okay, Miss Big Mouth, I got a deal for you. I'll go home right now.
Good.
If you go trick-or-treating up there to creepy old lady Bakewell's house. See? I could have told you.
Huh?
Hey, Russell! She got him.
Hey, what's the delay?
Russell and Melva been in there 1,100 million years.
Even longer than that. It's nearly 15 minutes.
You gotta do something, Fat Albert. You hear? That's my little sister in there.
And my little brother.
I'll see you dudes later.
Where are you going?
Let go, man. I'm gonna get the SWAT squad.
I'll give you a five-knuckle SWAT.
Easy, dudes. Easy. Keep cool. Follow me. I got a plan. Come on.
That's it. Good night.
Okay, Derry, take a run. We'll flip you up to the window.
I don't know. I got a Charlie horse. Or maybe a bad ankle. Yeah, that's it. Or maybe a...
Never mind. I'll go.
Whoa!
Uh-oh.
Get me down! Help!
Shut up!
Bucky.
Hey, Fabby Dabbit. You belong, righty?
Hey, I'm okay.
You gotta get my little sister out of there right now!
And what about my poor brother Russell, who's trapped in a room full of millions of alligators and snakes and spiders? A giant space squid, and...
Okay, I hear what you say. I'm going up there and ring that doorbell.
No, that'd give him a chance to hide evidence.
Wait,
We gotta rush the door right now.
We've been waiting for you. Won't you join us?
Mrs. Bakewell was telling us how nice it was to have some visitors for a change.
I haven't had much company since the mister passed on. Do try some of these.
Hey, hey, hey. This is really okay.
Be sure to hurry back. Bye.
Hey, hey, hey. You've been so nice, us dudes, that we're gonna come back Saturday and do your yard.
Yeah! And we're gonna do it absolutely free for nothing.
See ya!
Hey, bye-bye.
Bye. Yeah, bye now.
Bye-bye.
Yeah,
that's Miss Blackwell.
Cool, man. Right on.
You said it, man. Right on.
Old folks are great if you give them half a chance, huh?
It's like I always say, old people are A-okay. Melba, you okay? That old lady didn't hurt you, did she? Tell me you're okay.
I'll tell you. Let me down, you sap.
Hey, Devin, where were you? You missed a great feast.
Huh? Yeah, we had cookies, we had soda pop, and we had marshmallows.
Oh, yeah, candy! And all kinds of good stuff!
What? That mean old lady.
Mean old lady nothing. She's the greatest.
Yeah, you had her all wrong, Devery. Too bad you missed the big feed.
Come on, Russell. We better split for home.
Hey, all right, this man is all the way home. Yeah.
Heavy.
Hey, all right.
But that's no fair. I didn't get what's coming to me. When am I gonna get mine?
You're gonna get yours right now.
Dad. But Dad, let me explain. I'm innocent. It wasn't my fault. Honest, I was framed. I'm innocent.
No class.
Hey!
Oh, yeah.
Hey, 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 that was some Halloween, wouldn't you say? But you ain't seen nothing yet. We're all gonna be back at Christmas time with another big holiday special.
Where shall we go, Ethelbert? When Ethelbert comes out to play, he makes a new friend every day. He travels on a magic trail, Ethelbert, a tiger's tail.
It doesn't look too good. Ethelbert, where are you?
I'm here, Dilip.
Why are you crying, Ethelbert?
I'm scared of the dark.
A big tiger like you. Should we go on the raft, Ethelbert?
Waterfall with magic spray. Take us both so far away.
You can open your eyes now, Ethelbert. We're here now, Ethelbert.
It's still dark.
Open your eyes, Ethelbert.
Huh? Oh, that
That's better. It's nice and bright here. Wow, look at those hills, Dilip. Where are we?
We're in South America, Ethelbert. Let's go and explore.
Look, Dilip, look. I found a big black butterfly.
It's not a butterfly, Ethelbert. That is a bat.
That is a bat. Stop! I'm dizzy. She's crying, Dilip. Why is she crying?
Why don't you ask her?
Why are you crying?
I don't like daylight. It's scary.
It is?
I'm lost. I can't find my way home.
Oh, that's terrible.
I live in a cave, but I don't know where the entrance is.
Maybe we can help.
Let's try one and see.
Yeah, this one. It's dark. I'm scared, Dilip.
Don't be scared. We're nearly there. Follow me.
Come on, Ethelbert. Be brave. Wow!
So many lights! Ah! Is this place magic, Dilip?
Maybe it is, Ethelbert.
Thank you so much. I could never have found my way home without you. They look really happy, Dilip.
They do, don't they? Time to go, Ethelbert.
Look what I've brought back, Dilip.
Oh, yes, a stalactite.
Oh, it doesn't work, Dilip.
It will only glow in the dark, Ethelbert.
I like the dark.
You do?
Uh-huh. I'll never be afraid of the dark again.
What a brave tiger you are, Ethelbert.
Attention all ghosts! Attention all ghosts! Prepare for Operation Scare! Tower to planes, begin takeoffs! Pass were to go out and scare people.
If you please, sir, I don't like to scare people. I want to be friendly.
Friendly? That's insubordination. You're guilty of conduct unbecoming a ghost. I'm stripping you of your wings. And here's your dishonorable discharge.
Golly, now I can go and make lots of friends. Gee, there's a friendly-looking fella. Hello, mister. My name is Casper.
Ah! Let go!
Gosh. If at first you don't succeed, try again.
Thank you, little ghost.
Good evening, Mr. and Mrs. North and South American all ships at sea. Let's go to press. Flash, number one on America's Hero Parade today is Casper, the Friendly Ghost.
Ladies and gentlemen, I now give you the ghost of the town, Casper.
Casper, the friendly ghost, the friendliest ghost you know. So grown-ups might look at him with fright, the children all love him so. Casper, the friendly ghost, he couldn't be bad or mean. He'll romp and play, sing and dance all day.
That friendly ghost. If this keeps up, people will never be afraid of us. I've got an idea. Let's pull a scare attack on the television studio.
Yeah, that'll fix Casper.
Join in the spirit of fun.
Metropolis, I am honored to present you with the key to the city.
Thank you, sir. A skeleton key.
Casper,
for our strength, Casper.
I'm gonna exercise, and someday you'll be surprised at how big and strong I'll be. Golly, if I were big and strong, they'd never do half the things they do now. Uh-oh, an ogre. He's gonna scare someone, the meanie.
What's the big idea? Nobody likes to be frightened, especially out of his sleep.
Wow. Say, you're my cousin Powerhouse, aren't you?
Casper, I was just on my way to visit you.
Gosh, you sure are husky.
Well, I made myself strong to fight bullies.
I wish I could build up just to defend myself.
Well, I've got a case full of exercising equipment I can give you.
Wow.
I wonder how that puny Casper's getting along with his exercises.
Oh, that's trawling alike again.
I guess the ghostly trio won't bother you anymore, Casper.
I hope not. What's them? Coming home now. Wow, they sure are noisy. Quiet, please.
Who does that Casper think he is ordering us around?
Out!
Casper has exercised so hard, he's turned into a super ghost.
They think I'm you, Casper. They believe you suddenly developed muscles. That's a joke on them.
Now that Casper has become more powerful than us, we've got to do some thinking.
He'll stop us from our scare raids.
Say, we've got to do exactly what he did.
Huh?
We'll exercise. We'll become powerful ourselves.
Excuse me, Powerhouse. Well, I go and see what the ghostly trio are up to. I'll be right back.
Touch the ground without bending your knees, fatso.
Oh, I don't see what difference it makes.
Now for some weightlifting. Grab some logs.
What? When we're all tired out from calisthenics?
We've got to get as powerful as Casper.
All right, all right.
Hey, fellas, look. I can lift this big log real easy. I've become strong.
Why, it's just a hollow, dried-out old log. Wise guy! Casper, you're back to your normal, miserable size again.
Oh, well, you see, I've learned to reduce or grow at will. But I'm still very powerful, so don't get funny with me.
Yeah? Well, grow powerful. Right now.
First I have to get a running start.
Oh, we think you're kidding us.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Let me take care of this.
Convinced?
Ow, we're convinced.
Well, Casper, it was nice visiting with you, but I've got to be leaving now. Golly, so soon. I'm sure glad you came, Powerhouse.
You keep exercising, and you'll really get big and strong.
I sure will. Goodbye, Cousin Powerhouse.
So long, Casper.
Uh-oh. Fatso's been listening. He must know how we fooled him.
Wait till the guys hear this.
Where you been, you loafer? We've been exercising like crazy.
Let's throw him in the lake.
Wait, let me explain. Casper's a fake.
What did you say?
Casper had a powerful cousin visiting him.
So, that's it.
Are you sure, Fatso?
I saw both of them. Then that powerful guy took off and left.
Left, huh? Then that leaves Casper to us.
I've got to think of something to make them think I can grow big. But what can I do? That's it. My paints. I'll have to hurry. They'll be coming home soon, and they'll be real mad.
Now that we're mad enough, we'll scare the living daylights out of that Casper.
Oh, I hear them coming. I hope my scheme works.
Now, he's bigger than ever.
I sure am. Would you like to make something of it?
Please don't hurt us, Casper.
We didn't mean nothing.
They thought I was standing in front of the real house instead of this cutout painting I made. And to top it off, The exercising I did really developed a muscle.
In the woods, they heard a sound. Closer and closer it got, until...
Oh!
Then what happened? Sorry about scaring your friends. I got so into your story, I forgot to hide.
That's okay. They're not really my friends. They're my new Badger Scout troop. I wanted to impress them with a scary story. I think I did okay.
Wow, it's so cool you get to be a scout. They have songs and cookouts and badges and uniforms and secret handshakes.
I have a secret handshake. Even I don't know what it means.
Man, I wish I could be a scout.
You want to be a what?
A scout?
Good for you, kid. You got spirit. In fact, you are a spirit. A scout is the best thing a young creature could be.
It is?
You betcha. I may be made of parts from junkyards and cemeteries, but it was the Scare Scouts that really made a monster out of me. Are you thinking of starting up a troop? I'll be your scoutmaster. But I gotta ask you, do you all think you have what it takes to be a Scare Scout? You gotta be brave. You gotta have guts.
I got mine right here.
Then let's go for it! Welcome, campers, to the first meeting of the Disloyal Order of Scare Scouts. It's time to recite the Scare Scout Oath.
I promise, on my horror, to do my best, to do my worst, to be grim and ghastly, and to uphold the rules of Scare Scouting.
All right, time to teach you some wilderness skills. When villagers with torches come after you, you'll need to know how to handle yourselves in the woods.
I have a question about these villagers with torches.
Ah, where? Let's say you want to find the nearest haunted castle. You'll need a map. A good campfire is the surest way to... Ah, fire! Good work, gang. You've completed your survival training.
Can we have a cookout now? Oh, can we sing the Scare Scouts song?
Oh, Scare Scouts, you better beware, Scouts.
First, you gotta earn some demerit badges, which we're gonna do tomorrow. They're all here in the manual. Thatch, that was very rude. Well done. Have a demerit badge.
We want to be Scare Scouts, too.
Slither's already got a secret handshake. Show it to them, Slither. See you tomorrow, losers.
Okay, Scouts, are you ready to earn your first badge?
Totally.
Oh. Why, thank you, young man.
What in the underworld was that?
I helped an old lady across the street.
Thatch, show Casper how the Scare Scouts do things. You get a badge!
But he scared her. What did you think we'd be doing? You should have read the manual.
He's right. There's a demerit badge for giving nightmares, for haunting an attic, for chasing kittens.
But scouting is about helping people. It's about doing good deeds.
Are you out of your mind?
Well, badger scouting is.
To be fair, Casper, this is the Scare Scouts. That should have been a clue.
I thought it was just a catchy name. I quit.
Quit? No one quits the Scare Scouts!
Why not?
'Cause then they can't go to the Scare Scouts Jamboree!
Oh, Scare Scouts! Oh, Scare Scouts! You better beware, Scouts! Oh, Scare Scouts! Oh, Scare Scouts! You better beware, Scouts!
I really want to go to the Jamboree, but scaring people just seems...
Yeah, I know. Wrong. You have to make a choice, Casper.
Do you think the Scare Scouts would be open to change?
Come on, don't make a big thing out of this. If you don't want to be a Scare Scout, that's fine. But Ra and I, we're okay with it. You understand, right?
What the? Hey!
Excuse for a scout troop? I can't even look at you! You make me want to return my eyes to the lab they were stolen from!
It's not our fault.
Some wise guy keeps messing us up!
Then I want to know who it is.
According to this map, the Deedstown Museum is right down this path.
This is gonna be good.
What do you mean?
I'm the one who gave them that map.
They're heading right for the bee sanctuary.
Say, this isn't the Deedstown Museum. There it is.
I told you it was Casper who's been sabotaging us. He doesn't deserve to be a scout.
Badge blocking is a serious offense, Casper. I'm gonna have to ban you from the jamboree.
No!
Yes! Unless... Well, I checked out those sissy badger scouts you were talking about. They really do go around doing good deeds. Blech. Now, if you put a good scare into them, just maybe we'd let you back in.
Scare them? That's it? He should have to make them all cry like babies.
Good one. Yeah, make them all cry and you're back in. If not, you're out. And so are your friends.
Us? But that's not fair.
Hey, we're not the fair scouts. We're the scare scouts.
I'm sorry I dragged you into this, guys. It's all my fault.
Yes, it is.
But you know I can't do anything bad to Jimmy.
Look, you gotta do what you think is right.
Just don't forget who your friends are.
But Badger Scouts never cry. It's in the manual. Hang on. I think I have an idea. Tonight, we're having a cookout.
So?
You know, a cookout. Hamburgers, hot dogs, chili. Get it?
I think I do. I don't see any crying. I guess you losers are out of the Scare Scouts.
You're an idiot.
Chili's ready.
Smells great!
It's my pal's special recipe.
Whoa! This stuff is strong!
Great job! Thatch, give him your demerit badge.
Mine?
I forgot to order more.
Eddie's lip-melting hot sauce.
Give me my badge back.
Thatch!
Why do I have to be a waiter?
Because you tried to steal a Scare Scout's badge, and that's the worst crime a scout can commit. You're lucky to be here at all.
Waiter, more swamp water, and don't forget the garnish.
How you liking the jamboree, Casper? Is it everything you dreamed it would be?
Yeah, but to be honest, I don't think I'm scout material, and I'm okay with that.
Fire! Fire! Get it away from me! Put it out! Get the water from me! Fire!
have slowed down at once. Why are you rushing so?
Begging your pardon, Candace. We're passing Castle Dracula. And look.
Oh, nonsense. That old vampire has been gone for years. I rule Transylvania now, and I intend to keep it peaceful. What's that? Oh, that poor man is having trouble with his automobile. Let me see if you can help him.
Yes, Mum. Beg pardon, sir. May I be of assistance?
Yes, I think you can.
Hello, Ghostbusters. 7 days, 24 hours, Eddie Spencer talking. Who? Lord Mayor of Transylvania? What?
Count Dracula. We all thought he was finally gone for good, but he's returned, and he has captured our beloved ruler, the Dowager Countess, and her chauffeur. Can you help us?
Can we? We're on our way. Come on, guys. We got a job. Let's get into uniform.
Bring your garlic salami along, Tracy. You can eat it later.
Okey-dokey.
Oh, oh, boy. Transylvania's really in trouble now.
Let's go, Ghostbusters!
My beauty nap.
To Transylvania.
Oh no.
So, the Ghostbusters are coming to stop me from reclaiming my kingdom, eh? Well, they shall not succeed. Transylvania shall be mine once more. Right, slaves?
Right, master.
According to this map, we should be over Transylvania now.
And look, there's Jessica. Those reporters sure find a story fast.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is your TV reporter, Jessica Ray, speaking to you from Transylvania, where we landed moments ago to investigate reports that the dreaded vampire Dracula has returned.
Look, up in the sky.
Ghostbusters, as Lord Mayor of Transylvania, I welcome you.
Thank you, Lord Mayor, but I'm afraid we must hurry. Vampires hide during the day, and it's only 4 hours till sunrise. Which way is Castle Dracula?
That way.
Oh, what a story. I'm going too.
Castle Dracula, huh?
Looks like nobody's home. Let's go back.
No, we're going down. If you're scared, you can wait outside.
The head of a vampire bat.
Yes, the Dracula's family crest. Knock on the door, Eddie.
Knock on the door, Tracy.
Okie dokie.
This is Jessica Ray, reporting from Castle Dracula, where we're going to interview... whoever.
The door opened by itself.
We're going to catch a vampire. We'll have to go inside. That is the last Count Dracula. Some say he was thousands of years old.
Doesn't look a day over 500.
Slide open.
And look, a secret passageway. Let's go. Lighted candles. They look new.
That means someone has been here recently.
Listen, hear that? Who's playing the organ?
Not me.
Not me.
Me either.
Well, somebody is. And I think we better find out who. A problem, guys. Vampires aren't ghosts, so the dematerializer doesn't work on them.
You're right, Jake. But while you cannot attack me, I can attack you!
Tracy, get us out of here!
Okie dokie.
Just in time.
Oh, no! Jessica! Where's Jessica? We gotta get rid of that vampire before he gets Jessica, guys. Tracy, you still have that garlic salami?
Uh-huh.
Okay, good. Vampires hate garlic. They also hate mirrors.
I've got a mirror!
Great. And finally, we all know that sunlight will get rid of a vampire, right? Right.
then here's my plan.
Jake! Eddie! Tracy!
It's Jessica!
Can you get me out of here? Dracula's after me!
Coming right up! Let's go, guys! Tracy, the rope!
Okey-dokey.
Nice shot, Tracy!
To escape, eh? You are in my power, Jessica. So listen to my command. I will tell you exactly what I want you to do.
Be right there, Jessica. Jessica, come on! We'll get you out of here!
No, I will stay here.
Jessica, are you feeling all right?
I feel fine. I will stay here. I want to stay with my master.
Gee, I don't like the looks of this.
She's in a trance. Dracula must have gotten to her.
I'm afraid so. As a matter of fact, you will also be my slaves.
Look into the eyes of Dracula. Quick, guys, the specter shakes. Arr-hoo-hoo! Ha! It works! As long as we have these specter shades on, your evil eyes can't work on us. Then I will have to take your stupid shades off!
Fat chance, bat breath! There's three of us and only one of you!
Correction, Ghostbuster! There are three of you and there are four of us!
Uh-oh. I don't like the looks of this.
Time to put the plan into action. Let's go, guys. Don't get caught, but don't hurt anyone. Remember, these are people, not ghosts. Looks like a perfect place for our vampire trap. Let's go, Ghostbusters! Just in time!
There they are. We have you now.
Now what, Jake?
Now we let them catch us.
Are you crazy?
Don't worry, Eddie. This is all part of my plan.
Ah! Excellent work, slaves! The Ghostbusters added to my slave army. We can soon start to enslave all of Transylvania. The kingdom will be under my evil rule once more. But first, to turn the Ghostbusters into mindless zombies. Have you anything to say before I enslave your mind?
Yes, as a matter of fact, Batty, I do.
Tracy, your garlic salami!
Okay.
I could fly. No, he didn't. We wanted you to turn into a bat. Now we just attach you to this balloon and send you into the sky to wait for sunrise.
Nice try, Ghostbuster. But you forgot one thing. Not only can I turn into a bat, but I can turn back again.
Is this part of your plan?
Right, not Eddie. Look into my eyes.
No, my friends, I must not let them be enslaved. I must break free. I must.
What? So, you broke free of my mind spell. I'll just make a stronger one.
That's what you think, bad breath.
You're safe now, Countess. We're the Ghostbusters, and we just busted that vampire.
Wonderful! That means that Dracula won't be back until the next time there's a ring around the full moon.
Yeah, how often does that happen?
Every 100 years.
Oh, well, that gives us lots of time to stock up on garlic. Boy, Futura, you should have been there. I was really scared.
Sounds to me as if Jessica's love for her friends was stronger than Dracula's power.
Right. Friendship is a pretty strong thing. I mean, if you or Jess were in trouble, well, nothing could stop me from helping you. Nothing.
Me too.
Me too.
Well, that goes both ways, guys. Let's hear it for friendship. Hip, hip, hooray!
Hooray! Hooray!